Welcome to Inland Empire Alive, bringing you issues, events, and perspectives from throughout San Bernardino and Riverside counties. I'm David Brady, and in today's episode, I'll welcome back Michael Burrows, the Chief Executive Officer of San Bernardino International Airport, to talk about some exciting recent expansions to passenger service. That's today on Inland Empire Alive. Well, I am delighted to welcome back my next guest. Please join me in welcoming Michael Burrows, the Chief Executive Officer of San Bernardino International Airport. Michael, welcome back to the program.
Thanks for having me. It's great to be here.
So I'm going to borrow an Elvis metaphor. You've been taking care of business last couple of months. And we'll explain that in just a minute. But it's been a very busy period, we'll just say, for the airport. A lot of many long-awaited milestones. Before we had you, when we had you on last time, you were talking about just about announcing passenger service. So where are we at today?
Well, we're there. So August 4th of last year, we started flying out of San Bernardino, finally. 30 years in waiting, 30 years in preparation, training, if you will. And we finally were able to enter the commercial passenger market with our partners at Breeze Airways. So that was a direct flight to San Francisco with a through connection to Provo, Utah. And we've been flying ever since. And it's just been a really exciting time for our airport. And we were always destined to be in that space. We just had to find the right partner. And I'm so happy with our friends at Breeze.
Before we talk about some recent expansions to passenger service, let's go back all the way to the beginning and talk about kind of the history of this facility. There may be folks watching that really don't know about the history of SBD.
Well, as a local kid growing up in San Bernardino, it's just part of my upbringing. But we are originally Norton Air Force Base. And the local economy supported the base. The base supported the economy. And hopefully our airport begins to continue to take that role. And that transition, unfortunately, with the closure of the base, which was announced in 1988, really brought us through some tough times in the 1990s. And thankfully, we're up and flying, and we've been able to bring back many of the commercial elements of what Norton had. And Norton had passenger service amongst cargo and maintenance and a whole lot of business lines. And it's so exciting to be able to take the Leland F. Norton Terminal and introduce it to a whole new generation of customers.
And, well, you talk
that's
about
what we're doing.
The terminal.
Yes.
This does not look like a refurbished military facility made, you know, for the lowest bidder. These terminals are bright, they are modern, they are filled with natural light. Talk to me about kind of the vision you were looking for in designing these spaces to serve passengers.
Certainly, it's one of those things to always go back to your roots, and that's exactly what we did with the passenger terminal. So when you drive up curbside, you will see a modern facade. You'll see solar canopies in the parking lot. You know, the best technology can bring. But the actual bones of the terminal are the original Norton Terminal. We just brought it into this century with the latest in technology from the check-in counters on up to the concourse. And we're a modest four gates today, but we actually planned for the future and designed up to 10 gates so that as we grow, as our partners grow, we have the ability to grow with them. And that's not easy to do, but after you've spent 30 years working for it, you want to get it right. And I think we did.
So for these, you know, last couple of months that you have under your belt, what has the response been from passengers and folks, you know, with this pent-up demand?
It's really exciting. And sometimes I kind of have to pinch myself because there's times when I need to go and have a meeting with one of the crews or our great San Bernardino PD team that help us secure the terminal when we have flights. And I end up just talking to passengers. I love that. I love that because there's always a unique story of where they're going to go, who they're going to see, and I just love chatting them up. They may not like it, you know, they want to get on their way, but we've got some great success stories out there, some really personal, you know, reflections of people in our veteran community. I'm so excited to be able to offer this opportunity for them to do what many had done their whole lives, fly in and out of what was Norton Air Force Base. And that is just so rewarding to somebody like me, a local kid, being able to see that experience through different eyes.
So let's talk about now. Mm-hmm. Just a couple of weeks ago, you announced a pretty big expansion in terms of passenger service. So where are you flying now?
So we are flying every week to Las Vegas and on to New England, to Hartford, Connecticut. And nothing against our great partners at San Francisco and Provo, Utah, but my colleagues and I, when we first started the summer service, 9 times out of 10, we would get in the community, in the business community, in various circles, great, that's nice, but when are you going to fly to Vegas? And finally, I can say we're flying to Vegas. So it was mid-February, February 16th was the inaugural flight. I was on it.
You did it with a little bit of razzle dazzle.
We did.
Tell me about that. You brought a little bit of Las Vegas.
I brought Elvis to the airport, and that is in thanks to some additional partners we've added along the way. Our good friends at San Manuel and the Palms Casino really came out in force, and we had a great time. And that's the one thing you'll find about our airport. SBD is about having fun. If it wasn't fun, we wouldn't do it. And that's one of our sayings.
Well, I've heard you talk a lot about airports being really driven by partnerships. Mm-hmm. Talk to me a little bit about, you know, how that growth has been in the past couple of years. Because again, you know, you needed that partnership with an airline to offer passenger service. You needed the partnership with the, you know, the cargo services, you know, to keep that business running during the pandemic.
Well, it's kind of like a marriage at the end of the day. And you gotta find the right partner. And you got to find the right partner and listen to them and continue to listen to them. So hopefully my wife hears this because I'm listening. that's really been our business model, because as a you know, transitioning, realigned military base, going from closure to trying to commercialize every business line out there, we need help. You know, you're asset rich, cash poor, and you have to grow in a prudent but smart way, and hopefully we've done that along our journey. Obviously UPS put us on the map with air cargo several years ago. Now we have, you know, the top three national air cargo carriers flying every single day. Hopefully passenger follows that suit, and Breeze is one with David Neeleman, the founder who founded JetBlue, many other airlines. I've been chasing him my whole career, and thank God we got him.
So as you're looking to the future, what determines partners? What are you looking for in partners or markets that you may want to be chasing to try to service?
So one thing about SBD, and I encourage everybody to fly SBD, try it out, give us your feedback. We as I said, we're good listeners, and can always be better, but we want to make sure that customer experience is the best it can possibly be. And that comes to price, it comes to convenience, access. And one of the biggest surprises people react to is our cost structure. We want to be that local airport that can get you where you need to be without nickel and diming you. So you park your car at our terminal today, it's only $5 a day. And that's because we want to say thank you to the community for sticking with us all these years. But we also want to make sure they can get on their plane, they can get off their plane, and get where they need to go, see their family, see their friends, go to their business meeting, and have a good experience. And I think we offer that.
Before I let you go, I want to make sure we give a shout out. And you already said it, but the website is actually flysbd.com. So when you talk about FlySBD, you mean it, flysbd.com. Talk to me about the competitive nature of prices, because we know nowadays people are so sensitive about pricing. And you mentioned, you know, I hate to say it, but the nickel and diming, you know, that experience of when I fly, I'm getting charged a la carte for everything. I mean, and I know you can't speak, you know, as a representative of the airline, but just talk to me about, you know, when you partner with an airline, you know, what are you hoping for in terms of the experience they give, you know, the passengers that fly out of your facility?
Well, it's a nice parallel for us. And you always say you plan for this stuff, but circumstance avails itself, and you've got to be able to capture that opportunity. Thankfully, we did. Breeze is a very different product. It's a very different experience. They are hyper-focused on not just on their customer, but literally, if David was here, he would say, we are obsessed with being nice. And that is their entire business model. They want to be nice to their customers. They focus on that. And they provide extra leg room. They provide very, very affordable fares. The introductory fare to Vegas was $29 one way. I mean, that's unheard of. And that's the passion they have for what they do. And it's a bit infectious, so I gotta say, you know, you wanna do more, you wanna look for what's next on the horizon with partners like that. And it's very unique, but we're so fortunate to have them.
So for those watching, we wanna make sure we let people know how to look up flights out of SBD. Currently, right now, you can go to flybreeze.com, and you can also get there from flysbd.com as well. Absolutely. So we've got a couple minutes left. Talk to me a little bit about what are those kind of future-looking plans or, you know, wish list things you want to tackle, let's say, in the next 5-10 years?
So more passenger service, I believe, is very much going to be a reality for us. I get a lot of questions, okay, what's next, you know, any more airlines? And the reality is airports serve markets. And I love being able, through our partners at Breeze, to be able to open up those opportunities, because those are destinations. Those are tourist attractions, sure, like Las Vegas, but they're also opportunities to connect, you know, markets, but also cities with one another. And that really, from a local perspective, is exciting to me, to be able to pick up a phone and talk to somebody in Hartford, or talk to the mayor of Provo, Utah. That really opens doors and opens eyes, and that brings new business to our local area that we may not have gotten had we not been able to make those connections on the map. And I do see that expanding. We do have a role, I think, in the future, being able to continue to open up international markets, not just with our charter services, our business jet that we've had for many, many years, but really give the local community the best travel options possible. And that's what airports are here to do. And San Bernardino is no exception.
You know, we talked about this last time you were here. Talk to me a little bit about the notion of competition between airports. That, you know, everybody assumes there's this heated rivalry between SBD and Ontario, but in many ways, you don't look at it that way.
Well, when Ontario went through its journey for local control, which our industry just overwhelmingly supported, it's the right thing to do. If you're in this business, you just that's the way it should be. We've been, you know, well connected with our friends in Ontario, our cousins to the west, as I call them. But we really work very hard. I do, particularly, in making sure we're not directly competing with Ontario. The fact is, our Inland Empire region is home to 5 million people, yet we have one of the lowest available seat metrics in the country. This community needs travel options, and Ontario is a great airport. It's been an airport a lot longer than we have, and we learn from them, and we're better for it. So we can coexist, and our launch with Breeze proves that. Ontario's doing great. They've got year-over-year record traffic. I applaud them. And when I'm at various events with my colleague, Adif, over there at Ontario, we stand side by side. Because we are one region, one in an empire. And the community needs to understand, whether you fly out of Ontario or fly out of SBD, we're here to support you.
Michael Burrows, it has been a pleasure. I wish you all the best. Viva Las Vegas. Congratulations on the success. For folks watching, again, it is flysbd.com. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
If you'd like to be a guest on Inland Empire Alive, email us at guest@iealive.com.